ألا كل من لا يقتدي بأئمة فقسماته ضيزى عن الحق خارجا فخذهم عبيد الله عهوات قاسم سعيد أبو بكر سليمان خارجا.
Some insight into these seven fuqaha of Medina. Ubaydullah ibn Abdullah ibn Utbah ibn Mas'ud rahimahullah. He transmitted hadith from Aisha radiyallahu anha, Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu an, and Abu Huraira radiyallahu an. He passed away in either 94, 98 or 99 years after Hijrah. He was the teacher of the giant Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah. In addition to his knowledge of fiqh and hadith and his good character, he composed poetry. Urwa bin Az-Zubayr rahimahullah. He was born during the Khilafah of Uthman bin Affan radiyallahu an and passed away in 94 years after Hijrah. He was the son of Zubair ibn Awwam and Asma radiyallahu anha, the sister of Aisha radiyallahu anha. Urwa rahimahullah used to recite a quarter of the Quran by day whilst looking in the Quran, and he would recite the same quarter of the Quran by night during Salah. Urwa rahimahullah's desire was to be a practicing scholar, devoting his life to the sciences of Islam and then sharing the principles of deen with the entire creation of Allah. Urwa rahimahullah said, "Acquire knowledge and fulfill its rights. For indeed, being the youngest of the people, very soon Allah will make you the elders of the people through knowledge." Al-Qasim bin Muhammad bin Abu Bakr rahimahullah. He was the nephew of Aisha radiyallahu anha. He passed away in 108 years after Hijrah. He learned hadith and fiqh from his aunt Aisha radiyallahu anha and from Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu an. Abu al-Zinad Abdullah ibn Dakhwan, his student, said about him, "I never saw a faqih with more knowledge than al-Qasim rahimahullah. I never saw anyone who had more knowledge of the sunnah than him." It is clear that as well as piety, he had aspiration and intelligence. Imam Malik rahimahullah related that Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah said, "If I had authority in the matter, I would appoint the blind one of Banu Taym," referring to Al-Qasim bin Muhammad rahimahullah. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib rahimahullah. He was born during the Khilafah of Hazrat Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu an and passed away 93 years after Hijrah. According to Tafsir al-Tabari, Yazid ibn Abi Yazid said, "We used to ask Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib rahimahullah about the lawful and unlawful. He was the most knowledgeable of people." Sa'id rahimahullah met a great number of companions and took knowledge from them. He took half of his knowledge from Zayd bin Thabit radiyallahu an, and most of his transmissions was from Abu Huraira radiyallahu an, his father-in-law. Sa'id ibn Musayyib rahimahullah performed his salah in the first row with Takbir al-Ula in Masjid al-Nabawi for 40 consecutive years. For 30 years, Sa'id ibn Musayyib rahimahullah was present in the masjid when the Mu'adhin called the Adhan. Abu Bakr bin Abdul Rahman rahimahullah. He was born during the Khilafah of Umar bin Khattab radiyallahu an, passed away 94 years after Hijrah. He was devoted to worship and asceticism. He narrated a hadith from Aisha radiyallahu anha and Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha. Sulayman ibn Yasar rahimahullah. He passed away in the year 100 after Hijrah. He transmitted hadith from Zayd bin Thabit radiyallahu an, Abdullah bin Umar radiyallahu an, Abu Huraira radiyallahu an, and the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Maymuna radiyallahu anha, Aisha radiyallahu anha, and Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha. He was the overseer of the market of Medina when Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah was its governor. His knowledge and understanding of fiqh was increased by his study of people's affairs and knowledge of their states. Kharija ibn Zayd ibn Thabit rahimahullah. He passed away 100 years after Hijrah. Like his father Zayd radiyallahu an, he was well known for the science of the shares of inheritance. Worship moved him at the end of his life to withdraw and be alone. He is buried in Jannat al-Baqi. He lived in the time of Uthman bin Affan radiallahu anhu.